Hello, everybody. I hope you can hear me okay. We're doing something slightly different today. Two wheels instead of four. MotoGP came out a couple of days ago, I think. And I just started my career. I did one race so far. And this will be the second race. Let's start with easy AI difficulty. Let's go. So we're currently in the Red Bull Rookie Cup. That is the smallest class in the game. Let me know how the volume is of the game.
Hello
versus
to all you motorcycle fans tuning in. The MotoGP season is up to its 14th GP, and it's being held here in Spain at the Aragon Circuit.
A lot of tracks that I don't know. Hi, Michael. I'm not quite sure still if I want to play in third person or first person. Let me know if you have a preference of camera. Got a front brake and a rear brake that we need to operate. Change of direction is super difficult. We need to time it really well. Have to turn in super early. So I don't know, you guys let me know if you want to see first person or third person. This view is a little bit easier for me because you can see exactly how your bike is positioned. Yeah, I play with a controller. Wouldn't make much sense to drive with the steering wheel. Game is too loud. Let me change that real quick. Let's see if this is better. Is this better now? Thank you. The graphics are good, but not super impressive. I believe this is running on Unreal Engine 4. The tracks are not so detailed. Even if I'm driving or riding on a track that I know, kinda have to get used to how it looks. I think the tracks in Race Room look better. So the main brake obviously is the front brake, but towards the end of the braking phase you need to use a little bit of that rear brake as well, so you don't produce a low sider. It's not Unreal Engine 4, I thought it was. But MXGP3, that is Unreal Engine 4. Right? Actually, the sounds are pretty good, I think. Those bikes, they don't sound so exciting in real life either. Careful when you touch other riders, it's very easy to fall. You played MotoGP with the wheel, that's interesting. There is controllers for bike games, I believe, but they are not so cool, I think. Yeah, I don't know this track. You really have to lean back a lot to produce a wheelie, especially in these bikes, of course. It took me a while in the beginning to get used to the handling, but once you get the hang of it, it's actually quite fun. As I said, the most difficult thing is the turning timing. You have to prepare for the corners super early, shift your weight super early to get into the corner. And of course it's not a car, so it's not a Formula One car, so the corner speeds are much lower even than in a touring car, and the brake distances are much longer. Coming from car games, car racing games, it's you need to readjust everything you know. The AI is actually pretty quick. This is the easiest setting. Of course, I'm still a beginner. But in the past, I believe the AI was always too easy in the MotoGP games. Okay, that should be enough practice. I think we can go do a qualifying real quick. The official Isle of Man TT game, yeah. It looks pretty good from the screenshots. Definitely curious. Obviously everything will come down to how it handles. If it's not too arcadey, if it's similar to this, I could see myself having fun with it, sure. Didn't Ride 2 also have the Isle of Man, hello, or was it just a short layout of the Isle of Man?
We're here in Aragon. Only a few minutes to go.
Scripted, uh-huh. Well, we'll see what I can do. I'll just do a one lap or two. Still don't know the circuit at all. It's a bit forgiving, I have to say, over the curves. I mean, if you go off track, if you drive in the grass, you should get into much more trouble, I think. Maybe I should enable the track map, because I really don't know these tracks at all. Let me do that actually. The track map is very zoomed in, at least to see what's coming up. Doesn't help much that track map. It only shows like 50 meters ahead of you. One lap, let's go into the race. A setting to lower the grip of the track? Really? I've not seen that one yet. Let's to race. Hi, Alex. Aragon. It's getting cloudy.
Bikes have taken their places on the grid. The light is about to go out any second now. This is when the riders have to clear their minds.
Oops. Really hard to avoid all these drivers. Not easy to drive a smooth line, especially of course if you don't know the track and if you're not taking the corner at the right gear or the right speed, then it's becoming difficult to... Whoa! They are very good on the brake, the AI, but not so much in the corner and exit of the corner. Streaming. Wow. Do you guys watch the MotoGP in real life? It's always very entertaining. Also Moto 3 and Moto 2. When I catch it, it's always good fun. Game a bit dark in this. It is a bit dark, isn't it? Maybe I should adjust the gamma slightly. It could also be the weather, of course. Moto 3 is crazy how close the races are. Slipstream works. Yeah, it's back on Eurosport, isn't it, in Germany, MotoGP. There was a short period where it was on a different channel, if I remember correctly. So difficult to drive a smooth line, as I said earlier. But we will go on some tracks later that I know, then it's easier. Hi, Yves Marie. What was the sport one guy called? Eddie Mielke. He did a good job commentating though. He also did the Nordschleife 24-hour race this year. One more lap. As I said, this is just the second race of my career. Maybe I should change the AI difficulty to medium instead next time. Although they are pretty quick. Or I'm pretty slow, rather. Braking is difficult. Finding the right timing. So much longer brake distances than in the car. I remember in the old MotoGP games you had to shift your weight of the driver manually. Here I've only found one option to tuck in, either manually or automatically. Which is basically just happening on the straights, isn't it? Would be nice if you had to fight against the bike wanting to do a wheelie coming out of the corners. Last lap. So I'm driving without all the driving aids except the manual or automatic tuck-in, which is just, you know, on the straight line you would need to press a button to tuck in, so you goes like this, so that's not much of a, just a bit of an, bit annoying to keep pressing the button all the time. There's a setting for traction control, but it's off. Victory! I quite enjoy this game, to be honest. I've only played 2 or 3 hours now. I'll probably get bored of it at some point, but that's always with every game. Almost every game. Just nice to be able to play a game once in a while, sitting on the couch with a controller in hand instead of sweating your ass off in a simulator. Alright, well, I guess we move on to Moto3 now. You guys have any preferences in bikes? I like the KTM. but only because it has a Red Bull livery. This one is nice too. Let's go with this one. Do the real MotoGP bikes have traction control? Let me increase this a little bit so it gets a little bit brighter. Qatar. That's a night race, isn't it? Yeah, I have to see about GTA, because you know they stopped support for modding, or they contacted this modding group that created this tool, OpenIV, with a cease and desist letter, so now they had to take it offline, which means no more modding. And even if I have already installed a couple of mods, I'm not sure how long they will keep working. It would be a real shame if they would stop working.
Good evening from the desert of Qatar, where the first weekend of racing is about to get underway. This will kick off another season.
Is there any good tricks for setting up your bikes? Guided settings, okay, it's like an engineer. Ah, did I forget to change the AI difficulty? Good though, the headlights or the lights on the in the track, a bit flickering. The rider animation is really good. One of the best things in this game. Except the ragdoll physic when you crash, that looks a bit weird. Like it's not keeping up with the frames or something. Very stuttery, not very smooth. A nice tractor, a nice motorcycle track. Thank you. Let's just see if we can change the AI difficulty from here. Nope. Then we just jump right into the race. Yeah, those bikes sound a bit weird. But they sound exactly like this in real life.
Good evening from the LaSalle circuit. The long... have all lined up on the starting grid. We are mere seconds away from the start of what prompts.
Pushing everybody out of my way. Running super smooth as well with highest settings. Got like 200 frames here. But yeah, it's not looking spectacular. But good enough. The tracks could be a little bit nicer. Lacking quite a bit of detail. Either the AI is really good on the brakes, or I'm bad. Next race, we definitely need to increase the AI difficulty. although they are not so far off. There's this free camera for screenshots, it's pretty neat. Quite limited options though. No motion blur, just a little bit of depth of field. And can't get closer than this, and not further than that. Yeah, I think you're right. It's a console thing. They were probably aiming for 60 FPS on the consoles. Yeah, I would like that too. But I'm seeing already quite a few mods out there for MotoGP 17. So who knows? Might be possible with a mod. Also, there is an option for motion blur. You know, before you launch the game, there's this launcher thingy. And I've enabled motion blur and all the other effects. But I'm not seeing any motion blur. Only from an external camera when you watch a replay. Not during driving. It's very strange. And I've seen there's a mod that enables various effects in all cameras, so I might need to check that one out. Problem is that mod comes with some weird reshade settings that I'm not a big fan of. But probably easy enough to get rid of that. You know what, I should actually, well, let's finish this race and change the difficulty before the next race. You have to look quite far ahead in these bike games. Much more than in a car game. Because you have to lean into the corner and shift your weight much earlier. You also have to brake much earlier. but once you adapt it, it's actually quite nice. Took me an hour or so when I first launched the game. To realize that these are not F1 cars. I think I will just leave that race, change the difficulty to something more challenging, and do it over again, because I like the track. Oh, that's not what I wanted.
Good evening from the LaSalle.
I guess I need to go to options to change the difficulty settings. It's not in here. No. Is it at the beginning of the career that you need to change it? Confused now.
From the
you guys know how I can change the difficulty settings in my career? Okay. Well, I have to do it between the races, I guess. Then, whatever, I'll just... I don't want to do this race again, though. Then I'll just retire from this one. I also like the first person view, but it's difficult, really difficult to judge the position of your bike, and you can see much better what's going on in third person. And since I'm not sitting in a simulator, I don't really care so much either. So I just go next race, I guess, and then I can change the difficulty. Ah yeah, there it is. Maybe let's do 6 laps.
Good morning from the Termas Rio Hondo circuit.
A bit more than just textures, though, that you would need to change. Look at how flat this grass looks, and the tarmac has very simple shaders as well. Looks very old school. Let's try a lap in first person. Another track I don't know at all. easier when you can follow a rider. Judge how when to turn in and how much to turn in. Let's learn the track first. There's no brake markers either that I have seen. Well, some tracks have it, have them. See a little bit of rubber building up on the racing line. Which is good, helps me finding my braking points. The more tracks the better. But is there actually any racing series on this track? Oh, actually the isn't it the Blancpain FIA GT series? Racing on Termas via Honda? Not sure. For example, Aragon doesn't really look that great. And Qatar, I don't know. I would rather have Bahrain. Bahrain would be a cool track, I think. Okay, let's just jump into the race. Skip qualifying, just go to race.
And welcome to the Termaster Rio Hondo circuit. After a long...
Getting to shift. Wow, power slide. Difficult to stay in the slipstream. So tiny and thin, these bikes. Hard to stay in the same line. Thank you. actually some pretty good racing. Even though I came from last position. I would have totally crashed in real life doing this. And that. Erster Eindruck is relativ gut. Pretty good first impression. But not motorcycle rule game expert. It's getting mixed reviews on Steam. Some like it, some don't like it. But those who don't like it, their main criticism is that it's basically the same game as all the other Milestone games. Which for me, as such, is not really an argument, because I've not played those games in the last 10 years. So I don't really mind if it's the same. What is there is actually not bad, I think. This certainly has some flaws, like every other game, but I think it's fun. Probably gets boring after some time, but that's the same with every other game. My main criticism would be then the tracks would have needed a little bit more detail. Better shaders. It looks a bit outdated. But on the other hand, it runs super smooth. Having 200 frames right now on maximum settings. While streaming. Oops, that was the wrong button. So yeah, if it was for me, they could have added a bit more higher graphic settings. There is plenty of content in my opinion. You have the Red Bull Rookie Cup, Moto 3, Moto 2, Moto GP, and some historic Moto GP. Which for me is just nice to go up from Moto 3 to Moto GP. You have all the tracks that you want, that you need. I think at least it's the complete calendar. Blocked. Ay, ay, ay. That was late. Too late. It takes a while to get used to the controls, of course. The first hour I was playing this, I told to myself, what the fuck is this? But once you get used to it, and you learn how to approach the corners, and you learn how, when to brake and all those things, I think you can have some fun with it for sure. Now, if it's worth 50 euros to you, it's a different question. If you're on the budget, you might as well buy MotoGP 2015. It's basically the same game, and it's a quarter of the price. Obviously, you don't have the 2017 drivers or riders in there, and bikes and all that. So, yeah, depends on you if you think that's worth it or not. What I've read that they actually did improve was the sound of the bikes. Even though you can argue this doesn't really sound great. At least it sounds realistic though. Lap. Maybe I can still overtake somebody. I guess it's too late now. Checkered flag. It was fun though. Howdy, Paprika. Yeah, the graphics are not the best. Especially the track graphics. The asphalt and the grass, yeah, could definitely look much better. Circuit of the Americas. Let's do this. Smoke from exhaust pipes, yeah. I think when you're standing still at the start, you can see it, or?
A big hello to all our viewers from this.
Let's try and go to qualifying session.
From the circuit.
Those cinematics get repetitive very easily, very quickly. I like this track. Like I said, so difficult to these change of directions. You need to time them so good, so great. Otherwise, you're off the line immediately. Thank you. know. Is the Mool part of the MotoGP calendar? Because in that case, it's probably there. I don't think I've seen it so far. Yeah, would be nice, Peanut. I don't think Istanbul is used anymore. Last thing I heard was that a car dealership bought the track and is using it. I don't think any official racing events are held there anymore. At least in car racing, as far as I know. It's a shame though. Yeah, I really like that track. That's going to race.
A warm welcome to the United States to all our viewers. So, the race is about...
Hey, I'm on pole. See how long that lasts. Wow. That was a different line than mine. Damn, they are so good on the brake. Alright, I'm really bad, let's say this way. Thank you. so rude. I need to practice my braking points. Oops, sorry. Shortcut. And it's so easy to go offline. Hello. Oh no, oh no. No, I've not tried that mod yet. I thought I'd first try the game as it is for a while. And if it becomes too easy after some time, I'll definitely look at those mods. If I didn't lose interest by then already. But maybe, yeah. Is it worth checking out? Have you tried it? Shortcut. Tried once to break at the same point as the AI and I fell. Thank you. taking some major shortcuts. Oh man. They have magic brakes, man. Nice fight. I wish I could punch him. Ciao, Michele. Oopsala. Well, it makes for entertaining races with an AI that knows how to brake but doesn't know how to corner. Or maybe it's me still doing race car lines instead of motorbike lines. We're in the last lap already. Wow. Is that the last corner? Yeah. Ah! You see that slide? That was a fun race. Alright, let's go to Jerez. Thanks, Canyonero. That was fun indeed.
Greetings to all the bike fans tuning in. Hello and welcome to Heroes.
Why do you have this sequence for every session is beyond me. Going off track really doesn't feel that good. Feels much too stable. Like nothing is happening if you go over a curb or on the grass. Why be not have fun at work Friday night? Man, what's that? What's that all about?
Greetings to all you racing enthusiasts. The fourth race. Just a few more seconds for the race to start. Will those riders on the front row be able to make the most of their advantage?
Really need a punch button. Punch this guy next to me. Who was it that did that in MotoGP? There was a little punching, kicking going on at some point. Was it Pedrosa and Rossi? Don't remember exactly. Or Marquez and Rossi. Aha, barkeeper, I see. Well, enjoy. Getting tough for this AI. Thank you. that was too late. What a finish.
Greetings from Le Mans. Hello from Le Mans.
Going in the 24-hour circuit. Hello. Drive these with my steering wheel. Well, I could, I guess. Yeah, I'm sure you can. It's a bit sacrilegious, though, to drive to ride a bike with a steering wheel.
Hello and the riders have just...
Hey, pole position again. I like this corner, the one before this one. It's over a crest and the bike gets very light, you lose the grip, it's super fun. Ah, just a bit too much on the brake. Jump. pretty good racing. Cool. Let's watch the replay, and then this is gonna be a wrap up. Let me know if you wanna see more of MotoGP in the future, and I'll see you in the next time. Goodbye.